guys, we're going to talk about something that we haven't really talked about before, but it's really important, especially something that you're going to see as you start really implementing what we talk about in these lessons and start seeing results. Today, we're going to talk about how to manage referrals. And specifically, we're going to talk about the initial contact that you make of the referral. Now, caveat, we're not going to talk about your CRM. We're not going to talk about how you track referrals, none of that. But there is a right way and a wrong way to make first contact with a referral. And it's going to be the difference between becoming an order taker and somebody that still struggles to sign the referrals that you're given. As we always do, we tie in a lesson that I learned in the community to sales. And today it's going to be no different. Now, in today's lesson, much like a lot of lessons that we do, we're going to talk about the lessons that we learned in the community. Oftentimes, we're going to bring in a point of lexicon from the community and really the success that we had there, and then tie it in to the exact situation that you're going to see in your sales environment. So today we're going to talk about what we did in the community to get introduced to a girl when we were not the main person having the conversation. This could be at a friend's party. This could be at a wedding. This could be at an event downtown somewhere, wherever you live, but somewhere where you're not the primary person who knows most of the people, but maybe a friend or a family member does. And this lesson today is going to be awesome if you're introverted, anxious, really not all that confident, maybe really early on in the process, or you just need a pick-me-up. This allows you to go in and not have to be that point person and really have the same type of results. Now, in the community, when we would want to approach a girl that we were interested in, but we didn't have the confidence to make that first step, we had major approach anxiety, and we just didn't have the confidence to make a cold introduction to a girl. We had one of the more seasoned guys help us with this. And so I would tell him, hey, there's that girl that I want to talk to. She's in that group. And what he would do, and it might just be the both of us, or there might be a third person. It really just depends on the nature of the situation. But he would go and introduce himself to the group, having no target in mind, whereas I knew who my target was. And once he built up a value in that group, I could immediately just jump in and really have that value attached to me. And so then I just really start the process of setting the stage for meeting the girl that I want to talk to on my terms and having it really work for me. Now, the term that we use in the community for my role was a pivot. And what a pivot is somebody that opens up the conversation, builds up the value right away, and allows me to come in off of that pivot. It's tremendous. It's awesome. It's the quickest way to build value. Plus, at the same time, you get to see what that pivot does to actually build the value and have it in real time. But then you're not a passive part of it. But in essence, you get to actually have something from that. You get to meet some amazing women. And ideally, if you're on your game, you get the girl who you're interested in, your target, you get her to ask you for your number. Now, in sales, it's exactly the same thing. But right now, we're going to pivot, ironically, and talk about referrals. Now, there's a right and a wrong way to handle referrals. Now, the wrong way to handle referrals is to treat them like any other prospect, to put them through the exact same prospect as somebody that you meet cold. And the reason is, most times when you get a referral, they're already pre-warmed up, and you're making them go through a process that they don't need to go through and they don't want to go through. And in the end, the whole process is longer and more red tapey, if that's such a word. And they may sign up with you, but if they do, it's going to be barely. But most likely, they're not going to sign up with you. And most people, when they get a referral and they don't sign up, they're either thinking, number one, A, the referral wasn't a good one, or they're kind of subconsciously, or maybe even overtly, blaming the person who gave them a referral when it wasn't their problem to begin with. Now, I know some of you are asking, all right, Matt, if obviously that doesn't work, how exactly are you supposed to handle referrals? Well, really simple. We're going to mimic what we do in the community. We're going to adopt the concept of a pivot, except there's not going to be a pivot right there. The pivot is the person who is referring that person to you, and they're not there. But the key thing, just like in the community, there has to be a clear expectation of how they're going to refer them to you. So when I first started out, I didn't really develop this. Nobody showed it to me. I literally did it maybe once or twice and realized what a freaking gold mine it was. When I signed somebody up and they became a great customer, they were really happy, the process didn't end there. One thing that was left for them to do was really to close the loop for themselves. And I really wanted them to confirm for themselves that truly it was a great fit, and their thankfulness to me for being able to work with them and the value that I really gave to them, they could actually demonstrate that to me. And so one of the things that I would always tell them is, look, if I've done a really great job and you're happy working with me, then listen, everybody that I work with always sends me at least two people that are closed referrals. Now, if I've done a great job, I really need to get those in the next week or two. So it's really important for you to go out there and just let people know what we do. When you find somebody, this is what I need you to do. And we're going to cover that in a second. But on the other side of it, if I don't hear from you in the next couple of weeks, I'll just assume that maybe we're not really meant to work with each other. And at some point in time, I'm probably going to shift you over to Kalani. We talk about that a lot. But that is usually the impetus, because they don't want to work with Kalani. And so they spend the next week or two just scouring their friends, everybody they talk to, and they are doing business development for me pretty much the whole day until they get those two in. And more times than I can count, I would get a phone call or an email saying, Matt, here are these two people. This is exactly what you wanted me to get for you. And so that's what we're going to cover right now. When I actually gave them the instruction that they needed to get me referrals, and it wasn't a request, I wasn't asking them, it wasn't please do it, it was this is expected when you work with me. Everybody else does it, it's your turn to do it. I would ask them to get me a referral with usually within the end of business on the following week. So if it's a Monday or Wednesday, they need to get it by that following Friday. And I don't really care if they have 2 or 3 days fewer than the person who I might have signed up a couple days ago. It really doesn't matter. They're expected to do this. This is what it's part. This is what it means to be part of my tribe. Trust me, they'll do it every single time when the value is set high enough. So one of the things that I asked them to do was I needed a name, a phone number, an email. I had a small questionnaire that I needed them to have answered, and I needed them to actually complete the application. And you know, they haven't even talked to me yet. Think about that. They haven't even talked to me. And I want that application filled out. And I told them, do not submit anything to me if this person is wishy-washy or on the fence. I need to make sure that this person is ready to go. My schedule is already full. And again, I only book somebody who's better than the weakest client that I have. So I'm really not at the point where I'm trying to start from scratch with somebody to replace a weaker client. Especially considering I'm getting a lot of incoming phone calls anyway. So what really helps me out is having a referral that's pretty much filled out, ready to go. I can make one phone call to them, confirm a couple things, vet a couple things, and we're ready to go. And it's the fastest, easiest, most loyal sale that you'll ever get. And I didn't learn this in a sales training group. I didn't learn this in a sales training book. I learned it in an underground community here in San Diego. So when you get referrals, which is a big part of what we talk about here, managing that first contact and really structuring how things are set up before you talk to them is really important. If you get somebody that says, hey, here's my friend Bob, here's his phone number, go get him, well, that's not going to work for me. So I'm not going to call Bob. But I tell them, this is what I'm going to do. This is what I need. On the other hand, when you get this person who's developing referrals for me and they do all the advocacy for me, they walk the person through the whole thing, they have them fill out the application, and they have them send that to me, all the work's been done. It makes it a ton easier. And this is especially important when you have a downturn in some of the numbers you might get, because we all have ups and downs. The idea is to mitigate them out. But when you have a time where you may not be getting enough people in that you want to, and all of a sudden you get two people drop completed applications or contracts in your inbox, man, it just changes everything. Because then you don't have to worry about getting a zero or having low numbers when you're structuring things right, and you can literally have business delivered to you like a food delivery service on demand over and over and over again. It makes your job easy, you get higher numbers, you prospect less, and you can really spend more time doing what you want to do. And the best way to do that is to establish your pivot.